Mina, what's up, buddy? We're gonna test this thing for SkySkopes.
So, we've got a brand new MFD 5000 heavy lift drone for our friends at SkySkopes. I think they're in Michigan or something. SkySkopes, so we're gonna go test this one out. This is a Phoenix Lidar Edition special. This one's made like specifically for LiDAR sensors and such. So, should be cool. What do you think, Chris?
Sounds fancy.
This is Chris. He's good people. So he's our documenter today.
Documentation.
Mm-hmm. All right, so here it is. New one for SkySkopes. Can allow their Phoenix LiDAR Ranger sensor to fly. It's like 13 pounds, so it'll be able to fly for like 22, 25 minutes, so pretty good. So we're using the Lightbridge 2 radio.
So why does the controller look like that, Bobby?
Well, I like it. I think it's good. So this is Lightbridge 2, and I like this controller because it doesn't have many buttons. Therefore, the operator really can't mess it up. It's got a flight mode switch, and that's literally all we use on this. And we turn it on and off. Like, I like it. Less switches to hit on set. So, I don't know. So, we're running DJI Go app. And then on here, we've got the Jetty Profi box. And this is giving me telemetry that DJI doesn't give us. So in here, I have a current sensor, and it'll show me how many milliamps I've consumed, voltage on the packs, as well as my runtime. So, you're welcome. If you build big drones and you decide to go with something like this, you're welcome. Okay, power it up. Okay. All right, powering up. One-handed plug in. FPV camera. Calibrating compass.
This is why I go to the gym.
All right, so first flight for SkySkopes. See how we do here. This light test. And the very first liftoff. Cool, that's always really good. We like that. I love when it's like that smooth. But I mean, I guess I've been cheating, so I've got a program that I load in all of the MFDs when I set them up, so it presets the gains and everything. So this is where it should be. But I mean, I build them all by hand, so you never really know, I guess. FPV feed looks good. Current looks good. We're looking pretty good here. Chris was just asking me about power to weight, so this aircraft generates, I mean, I would comfortably say probably like 160. So 160 pounds of thrust. And this aircraft in its present state weighs 47 pounds. So our power to weight ratio is about 4-1 right now. So, not quite, like 3.5 or so. But yeah, it's good. And I did that on purpose because we would go on these film sets. Oh yeah, I love how we're just talking it like it's just flagging stuff. We'd go on film sets and such, and the director would be like, here's this 14-pound lens, like, please fly this for us. And what are you gonna say, no? Like, we could say no, but then they'd be like, yeah, whatever, we'll get someone else next time. So we did this first for the film world, and then now I think the LiDAR guys are really liking it because of the flight times they're gonna be able to get. So on a set of packs like this, they can fly down to about almost 10,000 milliamp hours, and we've consumed 2,500, so this is only a quarter of the flight time. So, yeah, it's good. I think it's got its own little niche, man. I think the drones right around like 55 pound all off weight are really gonna be, they're really gaining popularity. And then with this one, we're working on some overweight exemptions, and we can fly this at 75 pounds, so yeah, about it. We'll do an auto landing. So auto land. So pretty cool, man. I'll take that. I'll take that all day long. Hey, so what do you think?
That thing is amazing.
So you have a Spark. How does it compare to your Spark?
Well, it's slightly larger.
Okay. I should let you fly it.
You should let me fly it.
Okay, maybe next time.
Maybe next time.
See, look, all that flight, and we only took one dot. Just one dot. After all that flight, that's how much fuel we burned. We burned one dot's worth. Yeah, buddy.
Final thoughts?
I wish all first flights were that smooth. Man. I'm happier than a pig in mud. That's cool. But on this one, I did some cool little, like, everyone gets better. I have more time to improve it. I mean, you know, I put as much time as I can into R&D and things get better. Like, I just did this. Like, for example, customers were breaking their antenna mounts. So we made them out of a different material. So they're floppy, but they can't break. So little things, you know, built-in battery connectors and gray frames. Got some fans under here now, keeping everything cool. Thicker battery tray, so all sorts of cool things in here. So this is a built-in regulator, heat sink and regulator inside for 24 volt power to the LiDAR sensor, which is really cool. That's not in the film version, that's in the Phoenix LiDAR special version. Yeah, then this is a rail mount, so it's similar to the DJI M600, those tubes. And then this is my nice little 3D printed weight bracket. So this is a handle. So the drone dude's name is on this one because those guys got their MFD and they said, hey, where's the handle? And I said, what handle? And they're like, we want a handle to pick it up with. I said, okay, well, what do you want to do? And they're like, just make a battery plate that's got a handle. I said, okay. So they get the first one. So nice job, guys, you get it. So I'm still playing around with it. I gotta make it a little stronger, but it looks good. Sorry, SkySkopes, I'll send one of these for you once I'm done. But it just does that, and then it does that, and then it's a little lift and carry. Perfect. All right, let's get out of here, I'm freezing. Yeah, man, good stuff. Right, Chris?
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'll take it out to a field, like maybe Tuesday. Oh, no, I think it's supposed to snow Tuesday. Maybe like Thursday or something. And let it do some autonomous missions with Lychee. Yeah, good stuff. Chester.